In this problem, we're given two stacked blocks on a level surface, and we're pulling on the block combination with a force of 35 newtons pulling to the right. And we have kinetic friction between the bottom block and the floor with a coefficient of 0.25, and we have static friction between the blocks. So in the first part of the question, we're told to assume the top block doesn't slip as we accelerate the combination, and we want to find the acceleration of the blocks. So if the top block isn't slipping, there's no problem with thinking about the block combination as a single 4 kilogram mass. So the 4 kilograms of mass is being pulled to the right with this 35 newton force, but it also feels a kinetic friction force pulling to the left as it slides along the ground. To finish the force diagram here, we have the weight, mg, pulling down on the 4 kilogram combination, and a normal force pushing up with the same magnitude, mg. And the reason the normal force has a magnitude of mg here is that it guarantees the blocks will move horizontally along the floor. In other words, it's just canceling the force of gravity pointing downward and enforcing the constraint that the blocks are in contact with the floor. So now we can apply Newton's second law in the horizontal direction. All right, so we start from the beginning by saying F net equals ma, and we're doing the horizontal analysis here. So I could say this is an x component analysis of Newton's second law. Using the standard coordinate system where rightward is positive, we'll call the 35 newton force positive, so there's 35 newtons, and then minus this kinetic friction force, Fk. That's going to be equal to the total mass that we're accelerating here, which is 4 kilograms, times our unknown acceleration in the x direction. Now we can put in some details about the kinetic friction force. The kinetic friction force is given by mu k, the coefficient of kinetic friction, which is 0.25. multiplying the normal force, which was mg here. So we plug in the mass, 4 kilograms, and we'll use an approximation of 9.8 meters per second squared for g. And that's all equal to 4 kilograms times our x acceleration. So we can do this all at once in our calculator. We take 35 minus 0.25 times 4 times 9.8, and then we divide it by 4, and we'll get that acceleration. And when we run the numbers on this, we get 6.3 meters per second squared. Now in part B, we want to get the minimum coefficient of static friction so that the 1.5 kilogram block doesn't slip. So now we're just thinking about what's happening to the 1.5 kilogram block instead of the combination of blocks. And when we start to put force vectors into the diagram, we have the weight of that guy pointing downward and the normal force pointing upward to balance that weight. Then we have to ask what's going on with the static friction force here. The block is accelerating to the right, and it has a magnitude of 6.3 meters per second squared. And the only force that could be pushing it to the right is the friction force from the 2.5 kilogram block underneath it. So that friction force must point to the right. So that rough surface on the 2.5 kilogram block moving to the right is locked in to the bottom surface of the 1.5 kilogram block and pushing it to the right. Now, at some point, you could accelerate the system so rapidly that you'd overwhelm the static friction force and slipping would begin. And the result of that would be the 1.5 kilogram block slipping off the back of the 2.5 kilogram block, kind of like the old trick of pulling a tablecloth out from under the dishes. So what we want to determine here is actually the smallest possible static friction coefficient that will keep this thing locked in and accelerating at a rate of 6.3 meters per second squared. So we're going to assume the static friction force is maxed out, so just before being overwhelmed. And so this gives us a static friction force of mu s times the normal force. That's the expression for maximum static friction force right before it gives up. And so we can write this as mu s times mg. And now we apply Newton's second law in the horizontal direction to this 1.5 kilogram block. And we'll go ahead and start at the beginning again. That's F net in the x direction is equal to the mass we're looking at times its acceleration in the x direction. And F net this time in the horizontal direction is just the static friction force, which I can write as mu s times mg. And the acceleration is known to us, that's 6.3 meters per second squared, but I'm just gonna keep it symbolic for 1 second because I wanna point out that the mass cancels out of this. So we can actually find a pretty cool symbolic solution before we put the numbers in. I get that mu s, the coefficient of static friction corresponding to the static friction force being maxed out, is given by the acceleration we're looking at divided by g. So I end up with 6.3 meters per second squared divided by 9.8 meters per second squared. And we end up with a static friction coefficient of about 0.64. Now again, that's the minimum coefficient of static friction that's going to keep this block locked in place. The reason we know this is the minimum coefficient is that it corresponds to the static friction force being maxed out. We're right there on the cut line where any smaller static friction coefficient would result in this thing slipping. If you enjoyed this video or at least found it useful, check out another one by clicking one of the links on the left, or click the Zach's Lab logo on the right to explore dozens of physics and math playlists. As always, you can leave your questions, comments, and requests in the comments section below, and I'll get back to you within 24 hours. Thanks for watching Zach's Lab, and best of luck on your math and physics journey.